Welcome back, folks. What a game we've got going here. The score is knotted at 4 apiece, and the game's had everything you'd expect from these great players. Great pitching, timely hitting, daring base running, and a lot of fireworks between these two teams. The West has a new pitcher on the mound, and his name is Big Bob Griffith. Big Bob is 6'5" tall and a couple hundred pounds. He's a 20-year-old right-hander from the Columbus Elite Giants. And Griffith will be facing pitcher Louis Tiant, followed by Jake Stevens and George Giles, with DeHigo in the shadows if somebody reaches. And we'll see how this youngster holds up to the pressure of pitching in the ninth inning of such a big game. All right, here we go. Tiant digs in. He entered the game in the eighth and retired the West batters in orders. He swings from the left side, and he chokes up slightly on the bat. All right, Griffith takes the sign. He hurls. He swung on and missed by Tiant. That's strike one. Griffith also attended college in his home state of Tennessee. He's also called Schoolboy, and he's trying to teach a lesson to these batting students here. Griffith winds and throws. Curveball for strike two. That's what the players call the old Uncle Charlie. Big old jug handle curve. That pitch has sent many a hitter into other lines of work over the years, let me tell you. Now, Tiant's in a hole now, 0-2, and he's choking up even higher on the bat, just hoping to get a piece. Griffith takes a sign, winds, and throws ball one. Oh, my. Josh Gibson had tossed that one around the horn when the umpire's right hand came up. Hey, if that missed, it didn't miss by much. So the count is now ball one. Two strikes to the leadoff batter, Tiant. Griffith takes the sign from Gibson. He winds and fires. Oh, down goes Tiant. Whoa, whoa. He really spun Tiant's cap on that one and narrowly missing the old Milliner. Yeah, folks, I have to believe that Griffith was sending a message to Tiant for his knockdown of Turkey Stearns in the last inning. Griffith knows how to play this game, even though some of the other players out here have corns older than him. So the count is run to 2 balls, 2 strikes. Tiant digs in, and I mean digs in. He's not going to give an inch, folks. You know, scrapper. Griffith looks in. He shakes off Gibson. Another sign. All right, now he's ready. The windup. And the pitch. Strike three. Whoa, Tiant is mad. Yeah, he's jawing at the umpire. But I'm pretty sure it's in Spanish, which might be the only reason he's not being thrown out right out of here, right? All right, now the umpire's had enough, and Tiant's retreating into the dugout. Oh my. Tiant just threw his bat against the backstop. Man, he's scheming. Ooh-wah. Yeah, that pitch was at his knees, so Tiant must have thought it was off the plate. But folks, I've been watching this great game of baseball for 30 years, and I have yet to see a player win one of those arguments. No, no. Even your Clarence Darrow, he got no luck there. All right, now up steps Jake Stevens, the shortstop for the East. He's played the entire game. He's had plenty of action in field, and he's 1-for-4 at the plate. Little Jake Stevens. He was the heart and soul of the Homestead Grays team that was so great back in 1931. And now, even though this had such superstars as Josh Gibson, Smokey Joe Williams, Double Duty Radcliffe, and Vic Harris, Stevens was the glue that held that team together. All righty then. Griffith, he winds, he throws, that's strike one. That was a fastball at the knees. Peas at the knees. That's what he's throwing. Griffith takes the sign again. He winds. He throws. Swung on by Stevens. It's a liner into left. Suttles comes in. And uh-oh. Now he retreats. And he reaches up and makes the catch. Boy, Mule really misjudged that ball. He started in thinking it wasn't hit that hard, but it fooled him. And it nearly got by him. Now, if that ball gets by Mule, Stevens takes third. He probably, or possibly, he might circle the bases with his speed. Nevertheless, there are now 2 outs here in the top of the ninth. Nobody on for the East. And tie game, 4-4. And up steps George Giles. Giles, 0-for-4, has one error. Giles bats left, slightly closed stance. And we're set for the first pitch. Griffin winds, throw, strike one at the letters. That's a good pitch. But it's hard to hit when a pitch is thrown as hard as Griffith. And the players say it rises on the way to the plate. It's a rising ball. A rising fastball. Okay. Griffith looks in. Takes a sign. He rocks and fires. Ball one. Just outside. Counts one and one. Griffith seems to be hurrying a little out there. Gibson just motioned for the youngster to settle down. Griffith takes a long breath. Okay. He's ready now. Takes the sign. He winds and throws. Ball two. Again, outside. Now the first baseman, Buck Leonard, hustles over to the mound to calm the youngster down. Hey, Giles is a great hitter, granted, but you want to make him put the ball in play, especially with Martin DeHigo on deck. Okay, now we're set. Leonard's back at first. And Griffin takes the sign, sets, and throws. Ball three. That one was inside. He's thrown outside, now inside. And if he can just split the difference, he'll be all right. Griffith takes the sign. Hey, Giles squares the bunt. And the pitch is way out of the strike zone for ball four. My, Giles squared around just to give Griffith a little extra distraction. And it worked. So, we've got a runner on first in George Giles with Martin DeHigo coming to the plate. DeHigo has had some ups and downs so far today. He's had a few beautiful catches. A single in four at-bats, an RBI, and a run scored. But he's also run headlong into the center field wall and has committed a throwing error when the ball slipped from his hand. He can make everyone forget that if he gets a hold of one here. Alrighty. Griffith looks into Gibson, takes the sign, kind of set. Here's the pitch. DeHigo swings and misses. That looked like a really hard breaking curve, something the players call an in-shoot. Yes, Griffith takes a look over at Giles at first. Giles has a short lead over there. He takes a sign, comes, sets, and delivers. Giles running, the pitch is called, strike, and the throw down to second. He's safe. Like I said, Giles had a short lead, but what he had was what you call a walking lead on the pitch, and he was at full speed at about three steps. Gibson's throw to second was a good one, but just not in time. So the count is 0-2 to DeHigo with the go-ahead run, Giles in scoring position. Griffith really looks like he's sweating out there, and I don't blame him. He's fooling with the rosin bag out there, trying to dry his hands. Alrighty, now he's back in the rubber and he's ready. He takes the sign, checks on Giles, checks him again, and delivers. Whoa, DeHigo, check swing. Gibson's asking for an appeal from the first base umpire. Umpire, he said, he went around. That's strike three. Boy, DeHigo does not agree with that call. I don't know. He just drops his bat at the plate, and he runs out to center field. So, Griffith manages to work out of that minor jam, and it was no runs, no hits, no errors, and one man left on at the end of 8.5 innings. The score is 4-4. We'll be back.